All right, 888-31-TRUTH. We're talking about the extraordinary form, the Latin Mass, with Father Gismondi. Let's go to Kevin, as promised, in beautiful Boston. Hey, Kevin.
Hello, Patrick and Father. How are you?
Hi, Kevin.
Good.
Patrick, before I ask my question, I just have to say what an honor it is to speak to you and to thank you and the entire Catholic Answers staff for the service and the enrichment that you have provided to me in my journey throughout my faith. I cannot thank you enough for this show and all that you've done and the guests that you have.
Well,
you've been a real blessing, Patrick.
Thanks. Kevin, thank you for saying that. We appreciate it. This is the kind of thing that when our alarm goes off in the morning, we know we're doing a good thing, but it's so great to hear it, Kevin. I'm really glad the show is a blessing to you, and it's a whole team here at Catholic Answers behind this broadcast. It's not just little old me with the microphone, and Father Gismondi is a good example of the quality of the guests that we have. And I know you have a question for him tonight, Kevin.
I do, and you know, a lot of what you covered with Dawn helped answer some of my questions. But I'll ask it this way. In kind of in a reverse type of manner, when I go to daily Mass at my parish, you tend to hear the more extraordinary in the Latin on a weekday than you do on a Sunday. And I think that's because, you know, there's an older generation that tends to go to Mass more on a daily basis.
Mm-hmm.
So when I went, I actually felt much along the lines like you were talking with John, I felt excluded, like I wasn't able to participate because you know, I struggle enough with English, never mind Latin, right? and so, you know, I felt lost and excluded. And I got to thinking, you know, rather than it's a hurdle that you kind of have to overcome. So, Father, my question was, what's the best way to educate oneself to the language and to familiarize yourself and be able to be a full participant? And you kind of touched upon it when you made mention of the fact that, you know, many of the missals, and you can probably purchase the missals, which would have Latin on one side and you know, the English version on the other. But is there any other type of opportunities that might be out there that would help one familiarize themselves? Because I do want to participate.
Yeah.
I do think I'm kind of first-generation Vatican II type of guy. So.
Kevin, this is a different facet of the same diamond that Dom was approaching. How to, for someone who doesn't know much Latin, if at all, to learn enough that one has a greater comfort level and wants to enter into the extraordinary form.
Yeah, I think people get too tied up with the Latin. Don't worry about Latin. You don't have to know Latin to participate in the Mass. And I think once people understand that, then the Mass opens up. It's good to understand the Latin. It's good to know it. But, you know, when we think about, we have to think about what's going on. We are at the foot of the cross, and our Lord is presenting again the sacrifice that he did. And when we think about that, and, you know, if you go to Eucharistic adoration, silent adoration, you kneel there before our Lord, maybe just in the tabernacle without him being exposed. Or you can go to adoration with him exposed in the monstrance. Mm-hmm. And we have this inner conversation with Christ. At the Mass, at the extraordinary form, you can do the same thing. You kneel there and you have the inner conversation with Christ, except he's not just there in the Blessed Sacrament. He's in there, he's there at the Mass, present through the Blessed Sacrament as he was on the cross. So you are literally at the foot of the cross with Our Lady, St. Mary Magdalene, St. John. You know, if we think about it, time is something created. Christ brings you to the foot of the cross at the Mass. So don't get tied up with the Latin. It's good to learn Latin. It's good to be familiar with it. You know, you can have a missal and go. You know, it's the same every day, so you get familiar with it quickly. But I think too many people, especially in the beginning, get too caught up in that. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Kevin, is that a good starting point?
It's an excellent starting point. I appreciate it, Father. Thank you.
All right. Welcome. Keep the faith, Kevin. Thanks for the kind words, brother. God bless you.
Amen. God bless you both, too. Thank you.
All right. 51.